ago, the ancient country of Kiev and Rus was attacked by their enemies, a tribe called the Pechenegi. Early one morning, Russian Prince Yaroslav led his soldiers into a merciless battle. They fought all day, and by sunset the Kievans had won, forcing the Pechenegi to run away without a place to hide, ancient chronicles say. To celebrate this victory, Kiev citizens founded Sofia's Cathedral. It is known as one of the most intriguing wonders of Europe, filled with unsolved riddles and shrouded in mysterious secrets. When Sofia's Cathedral was founded in 1017, it was the largest building in Kiev. It was also the most important church in all of Kievan Rus. Besides religious services, this was also the place to greet foreign ambassadors and conduct the coronations of ancient nobility. Sofia's Cathedral is dedicated to the wisdom of Christianity. The word Sophia comes from the ancient Greek word Sophos, which translates into wisdom. So it is no surprise that Prince Yaroslav gave Sofia's Cathedral such a name. He was also called Yaroslav the Wise, because more than anything he appreciated books, education and intelligence. But there might be another reason the church was given that name. The most important cathedral in ancient Byzantium was also called Sofia. Kiev wanted to challenge Constantinople, and Russian architects developed their own style, which gives Sofia's Cathedral in Kiev its unique and unforgettable look. In the center of the church, located a large icon of Maria that raises her arms in prayer. People like to compare the icon of Maria with an indestructible wall. Along with the main altar, it has survived vandalism during wars, revolutions, and all other tragic events that happened in Kiev. The name of this icon is Oranta, which translates from Greek to the one who prays. Some believe that God's Mother prays for Kiev and its people, and as long as she is out of harm's way, Kiev is protected from danger. It looks like Maria is soaring over the church. This visual effect was created by the special way the mosaic was placed onto the curved wall of the church. In modern times, there are very few places in the world that have as many ancient mosaics as this temple. In the 17th century, the cathedral was reconstructed in the style of Ukrainian Baroque. The new style of the outer cathedral perfectly harmonizes with the preserved fragments of the ancient inner walls, including the oldest part of the cathedral, the frescoes, some of which date back to the 11th century. Creating frescoes was an extremely hard process. Artists had to create the whole fresco very high off the ground, directly onto a freshly plastered wall, including all the little details before the plaster dries. The smallest mistake could ruin the whole work, and the artist would have to start over from the beginning. Also amazing is the diversity of colors in Sofia's mosaics. Ancient artists used 18 basic colors with a total of 143 different shades. It's hard to imagine that 900 years ago people could do such work without electronic technology and only with the naked eye. Mosaics are made from small pieces of colored glass, called smalto. The hardest piece to make was the golden smalto, because underneath the glass was a very thin piece of real gold. Sofia's Cathedral is also well known for its golden sound. Unfortunately, people won't hear it anymore, because the cathedral is protected and services are rarely conducted here. The secret of its acoustics is here, in this small ceramic pot. Ancient architects placed thousands of them into the walls of the cathedral to act as resonators, which gives the cathedral the powerful sound of a modern musical system. Some of the mosaics on the floor are original and belong to the time of the cathedral's creation. The same goes for some of the bricks in the walls. The secret of their strength and long life is in the special recipe for the cement that they were made from. In this sarcophagus, the remains of Yaroslav the Wise were peacefully resting before it was looted by Mongols. One of the strangest mysteries of Sofia's Cathedral is connected with the disappearance of Yaroslav's famous library. It was the first book collection in ancient Russia. At the time when other European libraries proudly owned 200 or 300 books, Yaroslav's library had 1,000. Some historians believe that the library was hidden by his sons and that it still exists in the catacombs under the cathedral. Sofia's Cathedral is one of the most famous historical monuments in Ukraine. Its preservation is not only important for the historical heritage of Ukraine, but for the whole world. And that is why Sofia's Cathedral is now proudly under the protection of the United Nations. It has been the pleasure of us at 180 View to share this unique monument with Arizona students.
Once upon a time, before any European had set foot on the American continent, here in Arizona, life was very different. And today, we'll try to take a short look into the mysterious world that thrived here before us.
If you and I were the first settlers who came to explore the new lands of the American Southwest, this is how Arizona would amaze us. We see the unique beauty of desert landscapes, we feel hot, dry winds on our faces, and we're astonished by the types of plants never seen before. The diversity of pristine natural wonders this new world has to offer leaves us stunned and speechless. But what is this strange place? What people inhabited it, and where did they go? How and why did they build this mysterious castle on the face of this steep cliff? Even today, people of the 21st century don't have the answers to all of these questions. And many years ago, when Arizona's first settlers saw this monument to an ancient Native American civilization, they didn't exactly realize what they had discovered. They called it Montezuma Castle. The look of this dwelling reminded them of architecture seen in the Aztec Empire of Mexico. So settlers named this place after Emperor Montezuma II, who was defeated by the Spanish conquistadors. Today we know that Montezuma Castle doesn't have anything to do with Aztec culture, and it was here long before Emperor Montezuma was even born.
The people that inhabited Montezuma Castle were a group of Native Americans known as the Sanawa. They originated in Flagstaff, and after the eruption of Sunset Crater Volcano, a vast majority of that population moved down into the Verde Valley. They moved here in approximately the year 1100 AD, and for the next 325 years inhabited this area in multiple places, one of which is Montezuma Castle.
Even though we call this place a castle, it was not built to be a strong defensive fortress. It would be more correct to call it an enormous apartment with a wonderful view, 5 stories and 20 rooms of which once hosted up to 35 people.
The history of the castle, I mean, that these people were farmers, and I asked myself, why did they build a castle into the wall? My assumption was because there were tribes around here and they were fighting each other. Now I learned that this was not the case, that these were peaceful people.
Today we know that the Sinaguan people chose to settle in this unusual location for a number of different reasons. Just to the right of the base of the castle flows Beaver Creek, so the inhabitants were supplied with fresh water year-round. But the area around the creek was not suitable for building a house out of rocks and mud. It sits in a giant floodplain that periodically gets filled with creek water, which destroys everything in its way. Mother Nature gave the ancient Sinaguans a gift by creating a natural alcove in the limestone of the cliff's wall. But it was their unbelievably hard work that made this place livable. Wood beams, rocks, and mud were their main building materials, and the Sinaguans had to carry it up to the alcove on their own shoulders with the only aid of ropes and ladders made out of yucca. Some of the wood beams were extremely heavy. Made out of these tall and beautiful sycamore trees, they could weigh up to 1,000 pounds. But the hard work was worth it, and today, after 700 years, Montezuma Castle is still 90% of its original construction. Besides strength and beauty, sycamore trees are also known for their long life, so there is a chance that some of these very trees saw Montezuma Castle when it was bursting with life as a working home for many Native American families.
Life cannot exist without water. That's why the well, just like this, is usually the very first thing to build in every settlement. Ancient Sinaguans also had a well, but theirs was so beautiful and unique that it still amazes and surprises everyone who sees it.
Over thousands of years, as Earth continued to change, it created this natural wonder. It is a giant collapsed limestone cavern through which over 1 million gallons of artesian water flows every day. And even though Emperor Montezuma never had a drink of this water, we call this place Montezuma Well. Fresh water comes to the well from warm underground springs. It is highly carbonated and contains a 600 times higher concentration of dissolved carbon dioxide than normal. This creates a very unique environment that provides perfect survival conditions for several different species of plants and animals, like the rare kind of water scorpion and springtail, which are not found anywhere else in the world. For Native Americans, this place was sacred. Some of them believe that they came into this world through Montezuma Well. This is understandable, because Native Americans used water from the well to give life to their crops through several irrigation ditches they built. And amazingly, some of them are still in use by local people today. Montezuma Castle National Park Services are doing a great job preserving this unique historical site. As one of the first four American national monuments to be dedicated, Montezuma Castle has always attracted lots of tourists. Until 1951, visitors were still luckily allowed to go inside. But the only way in is the same one that the Sinaguans used centuries ago, by climbing up a series of ladders. Today, over 600,000 people from many different countries visit this amazing site every year. And allowing visitors inside would be very dangerous for the castle and simply impossible to arrange. Apparently, this doesn't take away from the experience, and Montezuma Castle impresses visitors from all over the world in many different ways.
Just overwhelming that it's just huge and beautiful and great.
It's a very beautiful place.
It's extravagant to see something built into the cliffside like that.
It's wonderful and it's very, comment dit, haut, very
high.
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 High. High. Very high. Mm. And they make with a hand. So that was difficult, but it's very wonderful and very high.
Just the way it looks, I guess, it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
It's just the way it's made, it's just made in dirt. It's just amazing how the people live there, 35 years old.
Est-ce que tu ressens quand tu vois ça?
Ouais. Comment dire impressionnant?
Impressionnant.
It's impressionnant.
Places like Montezuma Castle give their visitors a rare opportunity to look into an ancient culture that existed in this territory even longer than the United States has been a country. And we're very glad that 180 View can share this unique experience with our friends from Ukraine. Thank you very much for watching. This is Nadia Petri, reporting from Montezuma Castle National Park in Arizona.